Okay, so I'm recording it. This is Angie at My Chicken Scratch, and we're going to cover the holiday catalog, and we're going to make these beautiful bows. Okay, so if you guys have a question, you can type it into the chat box. If you guys are new and you've never used the chat box, all you have to do is create a free account with Ustream, and then you can participate in the chats. Also, you want to download an ad blocker so that you don't miss half of the stream, because here in just a couple minutes, all of a sudden you're going to get a commercial if you have not downloaded the ad blocker. So with Firefox, you just go and Google ad blocker, and same thing with Google Chrome. Yeah. Okay, so before we go over the catalog, I'm actually going to make these bows. I'll show you what page they're on. Right here on page 37, and let me get the die. So this is one of those dies that you can actually cut fabric with, and you can also cut three layers of the Designer Series paper with it, okay? So you could probably try four, I just did three. Okay, so I cut my piece of cardstock at 5 3/4, and that fits it across. And I just left it at the 12-inch, and it gave me about that much left over. I should have measured it. Okay, so we're going to start out with making the larger one first. And I found that using glue dots is a little bit easier. Okay, can you believe the dude beside us is mowing his yard now of all times? Sorry, dude, but it's kind of annoying. Okay, so I got all the pieces here, and let me get the die again. I'm going to show you. Where did I put it? Here it goes. The lawn mowing is getting to me. Okay, so here's this piece here. I'm using old retired paper because I already made three bows. I don't really need any more. Well, I might, but not right now. Okay, so there's all the pieces that you're going to get when you cut it out, okay? So to make this first one, this is like the larger bow. You're going to take this piece, take your bone folder, and give it a little curl. It's so easy. And then take your mini glue dots. And I put one on the end, on that end, and one on the end here, and then fold it over, and then fold it over, okay? Then you're going to take these two pieces, I call them the tails, and you're going to put a glue dot on this one, and on this one. And then I like that to be the back side where the seam is. And so I just put that back there and press. And you might want to use more than one glue dot. In fact, you do. I'm just doing this quickly. See? Now I take this piece here. I'm going to give it a little curl. And take two glue dots on each side, or you can put sticky strip on the whole thing. And then what you're going to do is wrap this, and that just seals. And I'm kind of crooked. I'm doing a messy job. Where's my scissors? Ah, get off there. Okay. So there's the larger one. Isn't that cute? See how easy that was? Okay. But you can't see yourself making them? Yes, you can. That's so easy. Okay. So now to make the smaller one, what you're going to do is take two of these, because this is the piece that you didn't use. And am I right? Yeah, I'm right. I just want to make sure. I'd hate to tell you wrong. Okay, so we're going to take these two, same thing. I got to get rid of that rhinestone. And we're going to take a glue dot and then seal it like that. Same thing on this one. You can really make them really fast and easy. And then you take those tails again, or fins, or whatever you call them. And let's see. I'm going to put a glue dot on this. And a glue dot on this. I like to put these together like that. And here's the thing. I'm going to overlap these because, like, if you look at this smaller one, if you think about it, you don't really want this to be way out here. Not that it'd go that far. I'm exaggerating. But I overlap them, okay? So what I'm going to do is just bring it out to, like, there. And then I'm going to attach this also to there. So I'm going to put a glue dot. You don't have to do this step. I just sometimes make things harder for myself. I don't think it's hard. And then this one. And I didn't do it the right distance. Well, let's do this. I'll attach that there and I'll lift this back up. So maybe attach this other one after the fact. Yeah. I would use sticky strip on this little wraparound piece. Is that one or two? Feels like two. Okay, I guess it isn't. Okay, so where's my bows at? Okay, so here's the bigger one. They compare. And then here's the smaller one. I kind of messed up on the wraparound right there, but see, it's smaller. Not by that much. I say just go with the big one. Okay, now this one, this is a double one, which is so cute. I'm almost done. Okay, so what you're gonna do is take one of the bikini tops and two of the fins and two of these pieces. They kind of look like bobbers. Okay, so we'll do the same thing. We're gonna give them a curl. The only thing, no, I have it right here. I was going to say I might be missing one piece. Okay, so these we're going to do the same thing. We're just going to close them up. Okay, hopefully you can see that. And then we'll put a glue dot on each end of these. Yay, the lawnmower's done. That's why I didn't stream live on Saturday, because it's like everybody mows their lawn on Saturday, so. Okay. So we'll put glue dot and a glue dot. So see, you're just going to stack these smaller ones on top of the larger one. And then we'll take our tails here. Hopefully I didn't confuse anybody. It's really easy. I thought it was going to be hard. But at first when I saw it, I was like, oh, that's not my thing. I like quick and easy. Well, this is quick and easy. And then the last piece is the little wraparound. See? There we have it. How many minutes was that? Not even 10 minutes, and I made 3 bows, lickety split. Isn't that awesome? I love it. Hey there. Okay, so we're about 10 minutes in. On the chat box, you guys let me know how many of you are new and never been to a live stream before. I think the chat box is a little slow. Okay, so easy. I'm gonna get these out of the way now, and we're gonna go over the holiday catalog. Of course, I gotta find it where I put it. Here we go. Okay, so we're gonna start with the front. Okay, you're new. Welcome. If you have any questions and I don't see it, you can just type Angie in the chat box and that will grab my attention. I try to look over every minute, couple minutes or so. Okay, so we're going to start on the first page and we're going to kind of go through this really quickly. The first page is the table setting. And what's different about this catalog, I guess you guys have already noticed, is that all the samples are in the front and then the actual product is in the back. So I like it. I know some people have said they don't, but I like change and I like the samples. They're really, really cute. So this is our Halloween page, and of course I love everything Halloween. I don't really have anything made yet. Well, I do. But you guys will see it next week because my 12 weeks of Halloween is starting. And so I'm saving what I've made so far because they're the 12 weeks of Halloween. okay, so I want to show you, let me grab my phone because I want to show you guys this interactive feature. I don't know if you guys have tried that yet. Where is my phone? There it is. Okay, so if you have an iPhone or, I don't know the other ones, I have the iPhone. And so what you're going to do is you're going to download the app called Layer, and it's L-A-Y-A-R, not E-R. And so I've already got it right here. And so when it opens up, what's important is, I don't know if you've done this, is that you need to leave it, you need to keep it still once you find where the content is. Okay, let me open it up all the way. Oh, there it goes. Look how cool that is.
Need something spooky to spice up your Halloween decor? Stampin' Up! Is here to help you spook the halls. Check out our adorable new Build-A-Banner Simply Created Kit and the Halloween Banner Simply Created Accessory Kit.
You can okay, design I'll your stop own it now. Kit and but the important thing is when you're using the Layer app,
in the holiday catalog.
Well,
or you can
let
make
me
it
stop
with just
it.
The accessories found in the
See, case. Look, like now, once I move it off the page, it just shows what's under here. So you have to keep it.
And some ink, like
see?
Here.
Like magic.
So to get started.
I love it.
You're going to need to purchase.
Okay, you've got it. Okay, so anytime you see this interactive symbol, then that means you can pull up a video. I think they're all videos. Yeah, because like if you wanted to see how to use the envelope liners, there's a video. Well, I'll just point them out on all the pages. So let's go back to this page. If you guys want to know, well, this is just the idea. So we'll kind of thumb through this really fast and get to the actual product. I love all the samples. Seriously, I do. In fact, there was a couple things I think I wasn't going to buy, but I bought it because the samples were so cute. So I love this page as much as I like the Halloween page, and I really love this. These boxes are so awesome. Very Jetsons. You know what? And each one of them has like different music and different sounds. Yes, but if you're thinking about getting an iPhone, wait, the next one's about to come out right around the corner. Okay, so I said I love these boxes. I love the bags. I think they're going to do well. All the samples are so pretty. Look. Okay, so here again is that table whatever thing. I don't do a whole lot for Thanksgiving, but I think it is very nice. And when we were at convention, they showed an idea of making like a scrapbook with all of these supplies. Like a, I can't think of my words. Ugh. Not a scrapbook, but like a journal type thing. It was really cute. So I really like these because they work with framelits, and anything that works with a framelit and a punch, I'm all over it. And I love the font for this and this one. So I bought this set for this image and this image and this image and this. I do like it though. I don't know what I'll use it for. Probably for my blessing mix, because I always make that every year. And I love the burlap ribbon. Let me grab that. It's so awesome. It reminds me of feed sacks. I grew up on a farm and it feels like the fabric of a feed sack. Okay. You know what? Well, I'll cover the designer series paper when we get to the end, because I'm going to show you every one of the sheets. I think it's so much better to see actually each sheet. So we'll cover all the DSP in a minute. I love this set. I love this set. And this set and this set. But I have to say, out of our Halloween stamp sets, this one is the one I've used a ton. In fact, this one's going to be the first week one of my 12 weeks of Halloween. It might be even week two. I don't know. I've made a couple things with this. And I love the paper. Love it, love it, love it. I haven't used the chalk marker yet. And y'all know that glitter I'm allergic to. But I bought it. I'm going to use it. I'm just going to put a face mask on. And of course, I love the washi tape. You guys got a sneak peek on my blog of a Halloween card I made with that. So I'll be showing that on my blog soon. Going to the next page. I love the ribbon. It's beautiful. Very elegant. And, you know, it's beautiful. Yep. What more can I say? It's beautiful. And the little stacks. I'm going to grab that really quick.
Ow.
Okay, so the awesome thing about this is that for a long time I've been saying that it's hard to mass produce products, because when we get a pack of designer series paper, there's only two sheets per design. And so, like, if you've got eight people coming to an event or 16 people taking your Stamp-A-Stack, it's hard to design projects that use all the sheets, because I usually favor one or two. So the beauty of this Seasons of Style designer series paper stacks is that it's only... I already used the other one. I used up all the other one. Let me grab another pack. I made these, I used this pack for my, one of my 3D convention swaps. So, okay, so there's the first one. And then here's the second one, which turns out to be like my favorites in the pack, next to the polka dot, the green and white polka dot. So if any of you guys are demonstrators, this is fantastic, and please buy them so maybe they'll keep putting them in the catalog, because this is going to be so awesome to have events. And so this was one of the projects I made to swap at convention. This holds a little Reese cup holder. And so I made a bunch of these for convention to pass out to my friends, mainly to the international ladies. They're so nice. And I could make these using one of these, 4x6. So I'm excited. Okay, so now that I've rattled on about that, let's see. The journaling tags, you guys have to see those. They are very cute. Did I buy everything? Almost. Not everything, but almost. These are so cute. I'm given the this and that journal. Well, hopefully I'm not going to ruin the surprise. I'm giving them to my nieces for Christmas. I dropped something. So, I'm jumping ahead of myself because we're not on that page yet, but I'm so excited about this because it can be a planner or a scrapbook, you know, a smash book, whatever. Okay, so I think these are going to, I think they're going to sell really well. That's why I ordered 5 of them. I'm going to go through them really fast. I like the colors too. Oh, come back here. Okay. Look, I love this. Dear Santa, to do. Let's be jolly. That's cute. Look at that. That's a lot of stuff. You can get a lot of mileage out of one of these. Merry and bright. You could actually make cards with some of these. Okay, so there is that whole pack. I'll show the paper in a little bit. I've seen people use the chevron punch. I've not used it yet, but I think it's really cute. Oh, I love this set right here. Fun with Christmas, because they will all fit, you know, in my little circle that I like using for everything. And I love this pretty print embossing folder. Can you be my niece? That's funny. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to get the guys. Ooh, my nephews. Okay, the stickers. You already saw the journal. The washi tape. I love all of it. Yeah, I don't think any of... Well, you know what? Actually, Isabel could possibly be watching my Ustream. She does sometimes watch. Isabel, you didn't hear this if you're watching me, honey. Okay, you know what? I have not opened this yet, so let's open it together. Of course, I'd have to find it first. I've got my nice little bucket here of everything. I didn't show you guys that. Okay, here it is. But let's look at this real quick, because I told you guys I loved it. But then I didn't show you. It's just like the other one, except it's so cute because it has that really awesome top to it. Okay. Okay, I'm all of a sudden forgetting how to assemble these things. I'm not sure why. Probably because I'm a little shaky. I didn't eat supper. Okay, so I'll tell you guys, I'm a rattler. You're getting that if this is your first time being here. But for 2 hours today, I was trying to figure out how to stream live where you could see my hands and my face at the same time. There is a feature. You can do it. I've seen people do it. But the software that they say to use, ugh, I can't master it. I mean, I tried for 2 hours. I was going to be so excited to share that with you guys, but... Oh well, I won't give up, but it might be another year before I figure it out. Okay, so anyway, isn't that stinking cute? You could put a couple cookies in there, some Christmas candy. You could even cover it up, make it Halloween. This could be my blessing mix box. Yeah, I'm going to use it a lot. You might get sick of seeing that. Okay, so let's open this together. If you, oh wait, is there a question? Oh no, that snowman is not scary. Mm-mm. I love them. Let me show you something. Okay, so when I first saw that, talk about a lane swerve. Sorry, I jumped from subject to subject really quickly. We call that a lane swerve. Okay, so when I first saw that, I was like, I don't know. Okay, but let's back up a second and let's go look at, this is why I love the samples. Sample sale product. Look how cute he is. Because, you know, normally we have an outline of a snowman. And then, okay, you stamp it in black. But you can't add any color to him because snowmen are white, typically. But look, we can now have pink and green and blue and pool party or cabana. What is that color? Coastal cabana. Whatever. I love him. I think you're going to like him once you start seeing samples. What is a blessing mix? I think I've got one on my shelf. How'd you like that lane swerve? Okay, so a blessing mix is, it's a cute little poem. I usually put it on the table for Thanksgiving. It's like a table setting. Look, I actually have a moth in there. Lovely. Well, that just goes to show how long it's been on my shelf. This one's, gosh, I would say this one's at least 5 years old, if not older. This is another one. It always has the same ingredients, the bugles, pretzels, candy corn, the orange slices, and peanuts. Thank God that's not, for some reason I put Hershey Kisses in it that year. That doesn't belong there. And then this is another one. Every year I have to make it. Okay. Pizza ordered. Man, I would kill for a pizza right about now. No, I wouldn't kill, but I'd be happy. Okay, so back to... Okay, they should sell them by the case. What should they sell by the case? Can I do one for... I don't know what y'all are talking about. Can you do one for Christmas? Oh, you mean like a blessing mix? What is this called? Simply Scent Snowflake Season Simply Scent. Yeah, I didn't even know what I was ordering. But it looked really cute. Ooh, what is this? That's neat. Oh, look at this. Okay, so we have an envelope and a snowflake, some thread, some dimensionals, and then we have some other little punch stuff. Let's go back to the catalog and look at the samples, because I think when I saw it I had an idea. I just don't remember what the idea was. That was so long ago. Well, yeah, right here. Oh, yes, an ornament to hang on the tree. There's a little hole right there. That's why I thought it was cute. Oh, yeah, see? And you don't have to use, like, this little piece here. I personally will probably use something bigger in there. Yeah, I know I will. And maybe something with color. I like it. Oh, and so you can mail the ornament. Oh, you know what you could do is you could put a picture of one of your kids in there. Oh my gosh, that would be so cute. Think about that. Heck yeah. I'm going to do that. I hope I don't forget. Somebody remind me. Hey, Michelle, if you're still on here, remind me next week. Postcard ornaments. Yep. Blessing mix. You can share. You ordered a bunch. Yeah. Unless you live next door. I'm not getting pizza. Okay, so let's go back to, where were we? Okay, now I know. We were on, because I covered the snowman. I think you're going to change your mind when you start seeing samples. I'm sure of it. I didn't get this set. I like it, but I wasn't real sure I would use it. So, I didn't get that. And I didn't get this. So, there were a few things I didn't get. I have to say, I got this set because I saw a sample, and I love the font. And I like this message right here, too. I love this. I think I use... Oh, yeah, I use that. That's on my product bundles. Yeah. Okay, so here's the foil sheets, the textured cardstock. Okay, I have to get this stamp set to show y'all just exactly how big he is. And by the way, I absolutely love the catalog too. Love it. I will say I wish there was more Halloween, but I'll make it work with what I have. Okay. This camera is going to drive me crazy. This dude, I know on the catalog, it's like, okay, he's pretty big. But seriously, he is huge. I don't know what I'm going to do with him. Yeah, I don't really know. Was there a sample in there? Somebody tell me, what would you use him for? Oh, he's right there. But it looks like he's cut out. With cardstock, he is not stamped for sure. He's cut out using an e-cutter, probably. There's that bird or dove or I don't know what that is, but it's a beautiful card. So I don't know. Anybody getting the deer head? Which one's going to be your Christmas card? The poinsettia? I'm going to move this out of the way so I don't destroy it. Okay, the ribbon, I love it, love it, love it. In fact, I used that on my swap card. No, I didn't. I didn't use it because I couldn't get enough. Where is my swap card? I'm gonna share the video this week. Okay, so here is... So, my swap card for convention... Originally started out, I used the washi tape, and I used the ribbon for the ornament. But I didn't have enough washi tape to do that many swaps, and I certainly did not have enough ribbon. So, and that was the full card. So then what I did was I made my favorite type of card, and I did the white layer. Let me take it out of here. And then, instead of using the ribbon, I cut small strips of the glimmer paper. Oh, darn, my little rhinestone is moved. Get in there. So what I did was I used designer series paper. I pinned the ends. And, yeah, I used the glimmer paper instead of the ribbon. But if I'd had enough ribbon, I would have used the ribbon. It would have been cute. Okay. Oh, and so I didn't have enough of this paper to do as many cards as I needed, so I used the other pack of paper in the catalog and made another color. Same card, just different color. Of course, this one's my favorite because it's just so bright, but this one's pretty. It's the same card, just different colors. No deer head for me. You're right, emboss him and add a bow around his neck. You're right, a bow around his neck would definitely give him something. We'll pretend we're choking him. I'm kidding. Okay, come here. We're gonna visually do this. now that I've talked bad about him. Well, not bad. I just don't know what I would do with him. See, there we go. Cute. I like him now. That's awesome. We could even do red instead of the, that's stinking cute, actually. Look, get a closer look. Isn't it? Thank you. Who was that? Oh, there was a Sampoy convention. Oh, I haven't... Yeah, convention. It's almost a blur now. Oh, here's one of those other... my poor ribbon just didn't survive. Let's see if I can find a better one. Nope. They all kind of got twisted and turned and... Oh, well. Let's see. What else do we want to look at? Same thing on the... Winter Frost paper stack. It comes with 24 sheets of one design and 24 of another design. I didn't get the Christmas tree either. I like it, but I'm too lazy to be honest. I would just want to stamp that thing just in red or green. And call it done. And I know you need to use your markers and color that stamp. Or maybe not. I don't know. It's not for me. Okay, I did get this. I haven't got to use it yet, but I love it. So if you guys get this, don't forget that there's a bundle here. I need to emphasize that make sure before you order that you look at all the bundle opportunities, because you can save quite a bit. Like this one is 15%. This one is 15%. That's a pretty good deal. There's several in here. Okay, I love all the banners. I haven't touched them. I didn't get Santa either. I mean, I'm thinking about it. I will probably break down eventually and get them, but I did not order him. So, yeah. See, there were some things I didn't get. I love these kits. In fact, I'm sending, I'll share that later. I'll stream again. I'm going to be sending these out to people. This set's cute. Several people made things with this for convention. Of course, I love this set. I love images that you can color. The only one I've used so far is the little reindeer. Love this set. I've used this and this and this, and you saw me use that. I don't think I got these, not yet. And I love this set. That's the greeting I used on my convention card. And I bought this. I wasn't going to get this, but I'm going to show you what made me get it. It's the samples. Look, right here. That card is what made me buy this, because it works with the circle framelits. Isn't that crazy? Or awesome, I should say. So this, all these pretty samples that they put in here, it's what sold me. Can't live without the ornament punch and the Christmas collectibles. That was what I used for my convention card, and that's a bundle, so that was awesome. I got this because if I decide to do the Advent thing, I love how they stamped them. They stamped them right here on the bags, or they did them and cut them out. So that's a really neat idea. I think I saw it on something else too. I don't know. Yeah, so I got it because of that. I love everything on this page. I did use this. I'm going to show you the Mary really quick, if I can find it. I almost damaged it. So you're definitely going to need the paper piercer to get this thing back out of the, what's it called, thinlet. It's really beautiful, isn't it? I love it. I'll be honest, I'm not sure how much I'll use it just because you gotta attach it. Like I said, I'm a little lazy sometimes when it comes to stamping. It's beautiful, but the glue dots are too big. You could use the liquid glue. That would be good. We've got the bows. I don't think I've opened those yet. I'd be happy to open them and show you. Oh, wax paper. I did read that. You're right. I just forgot. Sometimes things go in and right back out as about as quickly as it came in. Especially when I have 1,000 things going on. Okay, that seriously looks like a bikini top, doesn't it? But look how many you get. Okay, let me move this out of the way so you guys can get the full view of this. I can't remember how much it was, but... Okay, so there's one. I guess it probably says on the page, and I'm doing it the hard way. What's it say? How many? 10. Yeah, 5 each of 2 sizes. And they're double-sided. So, if you don't want to get the, oh, cool. That's nice. So bows are in. What's the other one? Whoa, that's a really big one. I'm going to have to make sure I buy wrapping paper for my Christmas presents this year using these colors. That way I could use those. Okay, what else? I already showed you the box. Showed you that. Okay, this, did I get the bow die? Oh, you missed it. I did, because I demonstrated how to make all the bows. I will, I'm recording it, and I'm going to load the recording just as soon as I'm done with it, okay? Well, maybe after I eat supper, then I'll load it. It has to, like, process for a little bit. But I showed how to use the die. You're going to love it, I promise. I gotta show you guys this box. I'm so glad I only ordered one. Well, I might order more later. Once I figure out what I'm gonna use it for. Look, it's so big it doesn't even fit in the camera view. I'm sure there's gonna be like a fantastic idea. Like, let me think about this. If I've gotta give somebody, well, let's open it and see. I got a little scared when I saw the packaging and I'm like, whoa, that thing is seriously huge. But it's probably great. I remember when my kids were in school, I used to drive all over town looking for the perfect container to put a dozen cookies in every single year. And my budget was I wanted to spend less than $1 on their container. And I didn't want to do what everybody else did and use those metal tin containers from, you know, the craft store. I wanted to be different. So I always looked for like pretty glass plates and just something different. So now that I'm looking at this big whopper of a box, I think it would be perfect for a dozen big cookies, or maybe 2 dozen medium size. Okay, so let's fold this thing. It's 6x6. Okay, listen, this girl don't read instructions on anything. I got a photo scanner this week, and I had my assistant read the instructions. I was like, yes, that's so awesome. I hate reading instructions. Either you're an instruction reader or you're not. And I'm definitely not. I'm a visual learner. Yeah, this is a nice size box. I still don't know what I'd use it for. But I think probably given... 6x6. I don't know. You guys got any ideas? You know, I'm going to grab a couple things. I'm going to show you. Okay, so I made this a couple years ago, or maybe it was last year. I don't know. All the years run together for me. What year was this? I don't think it was last year. It could have been. I was so proud of this thing. I absolutely love it. I still love it. I'm like, because it's a lot of detail, and I don't usually do that much detail. But I was thinking as I'm looking at this box, I'm like, whoa, I wish that it could be like table decoration. If I could find a big old scallop to put under there, I could make a big supersized, yeah. I don't know. I'm thinking a large blessing. Yeah, well, and you could cut the top off because, you know, I don't, and there's a couple projects on my blog where I actually cut the top off and I cut these sides off and I put crinkle paper and then I put something here, a scallop. Yeah, I'll have to create something fantastic, hopefully. Yeah, oh, absolutely. DSPN on the top and the sides just like this one. I'm not sure a handle would work on this one. I don't know. Maybe it would. I'm seriously going to look for a large scallop. I could cut one with that e-cutter. Hopefully. Oh, yeah, you're right. I could put one of these pretty bows. Let's see. Imagine if it was covered in pretty DSP. That would be awesome. Look at that. Yep. I'm happy I'm going to be home for the next month and a half. I'm not going anywhere. You'd have to drag me kicking and screaming. I've been out of town 5 times in less than 2 months. I am not going anywhere. Of course, something's going to probably happen now tomorrow, and I'm going to have to leave. Okay, I love this set. Love it, love it, love it. I already made a 12 Weeks of Halloween project, of course, using this one. But I was thinking that I could also use this Happy Thanksgiving for my blessing mix. I'll be honest and tell you, I have not used the envelope liner. I don't even think I've opened the thing. Nope, I haven't. Well, I haven't been here. Don't forget, if you order this, that's a bundle. And, okay, I just have to say, are these not the most stinking cute stamps ever? I'm not going to get them till next week because we couldn't get them until August 1st. So, of course, I got it on my order yesterday. But oh, look at this. They're so cute. I like this one too, but I love this one. I don't know why. I just do. And the back. Okay, so... sounds like a challenge. Everyone create, yes, everybody create something with the big, big box. I really think it's probably, somebody's going to come up with something fantastic. And I'm going to be like, oh, I need to order about 50 of them. Because I ordered a lot of these. I think I determined that that they cost a dollar, I think they're $1.40 a box. So, I'm like, well, okay, that's somewhere in my budget. Not that I have to give 30 of them away, but look at the difference. Oh, that might be cute together. Hmm, wouldn't it? Look at that. I like that. You can't really get the full... put goodies in for your neighbors. Oh, it has almost been an hour. Man, it just seems like it's only been like 30 minutes. Doesn't it? Does it seem like it's been 59 or 49 minutes already? Snowflake die cut and snowflake cookies. Don't say the word cookies. I love homemade cookies. I don't like store-bought cookies. The samples of the big box on page 6 are really cute. Let's see. Huh? What page? Oh. I'm like, there's no way. Yeah, they are cute. Look at that little pom-pom. And there's that chevron punch. they cut out the foil, the gold foil paper. Yeah, I don't trust myself to stamp on the box. They did. I would seriously mess up. But this one is really cute. Does anybody know how to make this box? Because Michelle wants to know how to make it. Michelle, are you still on here? Where do you see dark chocolate and sea salt? Oh, maybe you don't. You're saying that. A cookie in the little box and a mug in the... Oh, you're right. Yeah. I was thinking I could even make snowman soup and put it in here. Absolutely. Yeah. Because I can make a little packet of cocoa. Let's see. Yeah, cocoa. Hot cocoa. A candy cane. A little one. Hershey Kisses. And... the little teeny tiny marshmallows. Yes, snowman soup. That'd be cute. Okay. You're eating the cookie. Dab. Okay, so Michelle, I ask. Nobody said they know how to make that box yet. We'll figure it out. Somebody's gonna know. It's not that complicated. It's seriously just a piece of designer series paper standing up tall. But it would be nice if we knew the exact measurement so we wouldn't have to rework it. Okay, questions. You're right, if I mess up, I would cover it up. I would 100% mess it up, so there's no sense in me even trying it. And they stamped it, let's see. Well, you know what? Maybe if you stamped it before it was assembled, then I wouldn't mess it up. I could do that. Yeah, I don't know what I was thinking. So let's see. Yeah, we would just lay it flat like that, and I could do that. I feel like, oh, the designer series paper. I'm like standing here like a knot on the log. I couldn't figure out what I was supposed to be doing. Okay. I love designer series paper, especially now that we have those little stacks. So we'll cover the Christmas paper. I hope I didn't remove any. So this is the Season of Style. And, of course, I love the big green polka dots. Any polka dots I love. So this is the other side, which, is that the one? No, that's a different one. I like it all, and it coordinates together well. So that's what I'm the most excited about, is that on the other side, there's not a really ugly color. That goes well together. There's some green in here to pull it out. So if you make a box, and the same thing, I love this, but it's so nice that this coordinates with it. So if you make a box and this is the inside, you're okay. And this is my favorite print. And then this is, so these three are my favorites. But I still like all the rest of them. So then, what's on the back? Oh, see? How can you not like that? I say that's my favorite, but then I use that one for convention. So, oh well. This one, I like this pattern better than this pattern. I don't know why. I just do. Because I like green a lot. And... see, don't you love how these all coordinate so well together? Whoever came up with this pack, I love them. And this is the one I used on this. But I'm going to use all of them, so. Let's see. And I even like this one. I guess I could say I like this one the least, but anyway. Is that all of them? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that's all of them. Okay, so now for the Winter Frost, which this is another pack of really beautiful paper. I love this big snowflake. And see, the colors coordinate very well together. I guess I could stop saying that. You guys got it right. Beautiful. And smoky slate or gray, whatever. It's really in right now. Like that Eastern Elegance color. Deb, did you hear your message come across from Facebook? So here's another one. I don't know about that design, but I could use this one, so it doesn't matter. And then this one and this one. So they're all really nice, and they all coordinate together, which is lovely. This one got out of order. Oh, this piece right here, I don't really know what I'm going to do with this one. But, or these two, I should say. I could wrap a gift with them. It's like wrapping paper. You only get one of each in a pack, so. Now for my other favorite is the Halloween paper. I love this one. So I'm using this one on the first 12 weeks of Halloween. And this one's okay. I'm not sure I'll use it, but I'll use this one so much that it won't matter. And this one, I like. I like this one. This one's gonna be cute for little treat bags. And let's see. This one I've used for something. I like it, and I like this one a lot. I use this for a little treat thing, and I use this. Did I use? I don't know. I'm all confused now. It was the same thing, the same treat bag that I used, and I couldn't decide which one I liked better. I think I liked this one better. And this one, if you guys saw the, let me grab it. Where is it? Where'd I put it? Oh, never mind. I don't know where I put it. If you guys saw my blog this past week, you saw that I used the Cameo, and I cut out a cute little bag or box. And so I cut this designer series paper. First, I cut it here because I wanted to save this. You can't see it. So I cut it here because I wanted to save this. I think I'm going to put this in a picture frame. I don't know if you guys remember when we used to have the decor elements. We used to do frames. Well, I thought this would look really cute inside of a frame, wouldn't it? I'm going to go find one. So I cut that off to save it for later. And then I took this piece here, and I cut it off here, and I put this on the front of that box or bag. So now I've got this one to put on a bag, and then I'll save this little piece for something. And then I've got this one to put on a bag, and I'll save this for something else. So if you think about it, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's 7 projects right there that I can get out of one sheet of paper. And if you really wanted to be a penny pincher, you could technically cut out each one of these. Like ghostly gumdrops could be one. Choked cherries could be another. Mice cream. See what I'm saying? Like you could cut all of these out and use them separately. I love it. And this is nice also, but I really love this side. What have you missed? Holy cow, I'm sorry, you're almost at the tail end, but I'm recording it. So as soon as I'm done eating dinner, I will load. Can you have the 12 days of Halloween instead of 12 weeks? You know what? I was thinking if here's the thing. If all goes well and nothing major happens, I may do both. But something always happens in the fall. So, I don't know. Plus, my kids are getting older, and I've been taking more trips this year, spending more time with them because, man, in a few years, they're going to be gone. They're both in college, and so, so if it all comes together, I may do both, or if not, I'll just do the 12 weeks. I know it's kind of difficult because it's like one project a week, but I'll still be posting projects on my blog also. The 12 days of Halloween is sometimes really hard because I have to do, well, that's 12 videos and 12 instructions and 12 blog posts and 12 newsletters all in 2 weeks' time. That is seriously a lot of work, so I don't know. We'll see. I would love to do both. Okay, so this pack of paper, or this pattern, it was be my least favorite, but it does coordinate well with this sheet, I guess. I don't know. I probably won't use that one very much, to be honest. I like this one. We've got that little crushed curry spider in the middle. I wish we had a spider stamp to go with it. I like this one, and it goes well together. Okay, so love the Halloween. Gonna buy lots of it. I've already bought lots of it. So the last pack of paper is the sweater weather, I think. And let's see. I like this. I like this pattern. That one's okay. I don't know. I like this one. And I like this one. I could even use this for Christmas. I don't know if that's Smoky Slate or Crumb Cake or... I don't know. I need to look at the catalog. And I like the Houndstooth. Reminds me of a jacket I once had. And that one's okay. Yeah, I don't know. I like this one. These are manly. Or they're fall colors. Ooh, I like that one. Yay! I can use this one. I love it. And it goes with this one. So look how pretty that is together. Yay! See, I will get some use out of this pack. See, polka dots again. But I love these two together as well. Yep. Potential. Oh, there's another one I like. I don't care for that one too much, but I love this one. I bet people cringe when they hear me say I don't like something when they love it. I'm sorry. This is kind of different, but I'm thinking this would be good for my blessing mix too. Oh, but I love this one, so I don't know. Okay, I think that's all of them. And it's officially been 4 minutes. That's pretty good. Yes, I'm recording it. Okay, so you guys, can somebody tell me how many did we have on here at one time? I'm sure we've already lost a few now, but how many did we have? On my screen, it doesn't tell me anymore. It's so frustrating. I think the chat box has stopped working. I haven't seen it move. Oh, there it went. Look, I'm going to put my favorite on top, or one of my favorites on top. Was the lighting okay for you guys? You know, when I looked at the Weather Channel this morning, it actually said that it was going to be... We were going to have thunderstorms at this time. I'm like, oh no, what if I lose my electricity? But it is not storming. Thank goodness. It says 90 now. Okay, cool. Awesome. Well, I think we are done. Yeah, but here's the thing. Is there any chance that there's a Janie or a Michelle on here? Michelle, my downline, not you, another Michelle. I gave away blog candy, I did a drawing the last time I did a live stream, and two of the ladies never claimed their prize, and I still want to get it to them, but I don't have their email, and I don't have their, I don't have their email. I don't have their address, so I can't send it to them. Anyway, if you guys want, I'm going to give a couple gifts to those of you that stayed to the very end. So, if you go to my blog post for today, I know on there I said that if you make a suggestion for my free gifts that I'm giving away, well, you can ignore that question and you can just say you're entering to win the live stream, and I'll draw a couple names and post it on my website on Monday. Actually, no, I'm not. I'm not going to post it on Monday. I'm going to draw the name tomorrow morning, because here's the thing. Once this video goes live on YouTube, people from YouTube that didn't attend the live event's going to come over and they're going to start leaving comments because they're going to hear this. Ugh, I should have stopped the recording. Darn. Somebody remind me that next time. Okay, so sorry for those of you that are watching it after the fact, but I have to reward those that attend live. So leave me a comment. I'm going to draw the winner tomorrow. I'll post the name on Facebook tomorrow, but I'll wait and post it on my blog on Monday, because I don't post on the weekends. But I will draw the name tomorrow morning early, okay, to make sure I get all you live streamers. Okay, well, thanks a lot, guys. If you have any questions, let me know.